You'd be amazed how much footage we take during these car club events. Unfortunately, we can't use all of it. However, here is a selection of raw footage for your entertainment.
Thank you. cars there, race cars down here.
Not as keen.
No?
Thank you.
Thank you. with that.
Realized halfway through.
Oh no.
Oh, I threw it right in the middle. I'm so gutted.
No, don't worry.
Oh, so frustrating, isn't it?
Thank you.
Takes time. Takes time.
That's that time of day, mate. What do you want from me?
I don't know. You're the man with the gift of the gab.
Not today, man. Today I'm the man.
Atherfield, 2015.
Yes.
It's a dust bowl.
It gets progressively worse throughout the day, though, doesn't it? I mean, at the start of the day, I mean, the grass still looks somewhat decent. But we've been running for, what, 5 hours now?
Yeah.
So we've got the racing lines in place, but we also have the dust in full effect, and that makes things interesting for the drivers.
It does make,
the photographers,
yeah,
the observers, the marshals, who probably need gas masks. Yeah.
I mean, I've just been out, and say, you stay on the racing line, it's dusty and it's grippy.
Yeah.
But as soon as you deviate from that racing line, it's almost like being on round one again, and you're like, way, and we're all over the shop.
It's so. The same in the rallying, isn't it? Because in the WRC, they have a rule where the points leader has to go first on every stage. And it's like, well, that means I'm able to sweep up.
Yeah, that's
rocks
it.
Rocks everywhere.
Exactly, yeah.
And obviously he kicks the rocks up, and then the rest of the field have it a bit easier, but it seems as though today has actually been relatively calm. We haven't had anyone roll over yet, which apparently is rare for this place.
And a shower, sometimes you get a shower and that really sticks the cats amongst the pigeons.
I can imagine that being interesting. Yeah. I haven't had that since I've been coming. But
no, I've never done this on a rainy day, but I've had it where I go, oh, a shower. Yeah, just literally 3 minutes.
Uh-oh.
And that.
Yeah.
So I genuinely haven't been paying attention. So who's our main contenders for today? You haven't paid attention either.
No, I'm fine. I've paid some attention, but it's just funny the way you came out with it. Well, I mean, Ryan Munns at one point looked to be completely out of the running. He wasn't even in the
And there's
top
a career
30.
Involved in that.
Of course, because he betted, didn't he, if he got beat by Steve Wells.
So where is
Munty's, I think it's third or fourth at this point in time.
Is Steve ahead of him then?
Oh,
nostril shots.
Giggity. Oh, what is this? I can't remember. It's one of the Morgans, I think, he's leading at the moment.
Right, he's on slowdown, let the other guy starts.
Because I don't know down who's leading run by run, because that's in the timing and scoring anyway.
We've got to be coming.
So,
here we go.
I've got technology has made me lazy.
Tony Long.
No, that's not right. That's a 32.
Tony
Why is
Long
Tony
32?
Long got 32
He's
seconds?
He's winning.
Wow, that's amazing. That is amazing. He's the man.
Do you want me to go and move the cone back?
He's
in
all
place?
Over that. Good start.
So. God, I risked that. So who was it? Dan's gen.
We're away with that one.
No, we missed it. It was Adam. Adam Morgan. Yeah, Adam Morgan. The Morgan family are really quick. It's really
it's a veteran day. Veteran day, mate.
Yeah. Father's Day.
Yeah, Father's
Day. It's Father's Day.
Awesome.
Thank you. camera, mate, because I've got yeah. Can I just sit there? Sorry. Imagine that never happened.
I do hope you've got some footage of the Mercedes C-Class, though.
I have,
yes.
I have.
It's been struggling yeah. on corner exit, let's say.
On really?
Yeah, just a little bit, you know.
To get in the back end out sort of thing? Or?
Back end out, and then the back end decides to be the front end.
Like the MR2 did, first thing.
The MR2, they've conquered it. Early on it looked as though they were going to be very skitty all day, but they seem to have conquered mid-engine motoring.
Perfect.
Balancing it on the throttle, and now they're in business, and we've got the Nissan out at the moment. He's just passed his licence as well, hasn't he? So he's doing well for himself.
Definitely. I was worried for it. He put in a brilliant banker lamp on the first.
He did actually,
first round,
didn't he?
He's
very, very careful with himself, which is always good.
So. Yeah. Who's winning? So who's it? So what are we? We're now on round five.
Round five, although one guy's done round six for reasons.
Oh, I've been marshalling.
That's me. Yeah. So marshalling next.
So, who's your money on for winning today?
A Subaru.
Dan kidding.
Morgan, I should think.
Yeah, I'm tempted to go with Dan.
£5 on Dan Morgan.
Yeah. Yeah,
I'll
make sure.
I'll make sure I've got a fucking. Yeah, but I have to bet who I'm going to, I reckon. I forgot his name.
Adam or
yeah. No,
Ryan Munn? No. Tony Long?
No.
Chris is doing well, he's special. He's down in the 120.
Where's he going?
Is it Pittsburgh? Chris Lee? No.
Love you, Chris. He's become the butt of all the jokes today. I'm not sure it's entirely fair, but it's kind of funny. Yeah, but I had a show on Downforce Radio recently where the butt of the joke became Lewis Hamilton. So, you know.
So, is it definitely a four wheel drive circuit?
Yes.
Got a man in a rear wheel drive special. Two specials.
Mm. But no, it's definitely a four-wheel drive circuit. It's definitely a Subaru circuit, isn't
yeah.
it? It's
just the Evo's doing all right, but yeah,
the Evo's doing all right. I think the driver's holding it back a little bit.
I think the Subarus are just modified big. Aren't they? I mean, the Evo's running road tires effectively.
Yep.
All the Subarus have got knobbly tyres and stripped out interiors, haven't they?
Oh yeah.
And the drivers are quite experienced, so...
Yeah, I mean, that's the
they
thing.
They need their own championship now.
Too many Subarus!
The senior championship. We have a Subaru championship, an MX-5 championship, and then a miscellaneous
kind of rest of the world. I really want someone to come in a Class 1. I'm a real Class 1 fan. I'm gutted there's nobody else.
Yeah, you see, you would have had a Class 1 with the Nissan, but it's been stripped out, so it's Class 3. I mean,
my Skoda, should have brought should have kept the Skoda.
My 1.4 Skoda's sniffing action. Yeah. Someone can give me a trailer and teach me how to use a trailer.
Just make it road legal.
Yeah. And get my driving license.
You might as well just get it road legal.
That's what like being old
drive anything, can't we?
Yeah. Might take a lot to get that Skoda Fabia road legal. Don't even get me started.